What we're looking at is a simulation of dust moving through gas. So astronomers actually spend a lot of time thinking about dust because dust is ubiquitous in the gas and medium between stars. And in fact, pretty much all the heavy elements in the universe are actually concentrated in little dust grains. So if you care about the things that made us or the things that made planets or pretty much anything that's not, you know, boring hydrogen and helium, you have to care about dust. We've discovered a new instability or mechanism by which dust and gas interact across a tremendous range of physical scales in different types of systems. Everything from atmospheres with rain and clouds and dust and smog, through seeds of planets, through gas and dust that fills the space between the stars and galaxies. We've been trying to understand for literally hundreds of years how planets form, and the biggest challenge has been understanding how you build the seeds of the planets. And that's one area where this could really dramatically change our picture of how that happens. It's a lot easier if I can draw it on the board and show a sort of visual example of how this works. You can start with tiny grains of dust, and these might wander into each other and collide and stick into a bigger dust grain. But then the problem is this gets bigger and bigger until you get to maybe a centimeter size object. And they don't stick together. Gravity doesn't pull two pebbles together very strongly, so you need some huge object in order to pull things onto it with its own gravity. And everything, you know, in between here is just a big mystery. In the new picture, none of this in the middle actually happens. And the idea is that you just skip basically from these tiny dust grains all the way to this giant object. So you get lots and lots and lots of these little tiny dust grains, clump them all together until they become so many in such a small space that gravity just pulls them all together into this giant object. So how does this actually happen? How do the dust grains actually clump together? To explain that, let's think about stuff moving through our atmosphere where we have some intuition. Let's ask what happens if we have a giant object like a bowling ball moving through the air. You drop it out of a plane. So you push the atoms and molecules in the air out of the way as you fall down towards the ground. And if there were just the one bowling ball, that would pretty much be the end of the story. The difference is you've now got a whole fleet of bowling balls that are all falling down at the same time. So there's another one over here and another one over here, and this one's falling down and pushing the air out of the way. But so is this one. It's also pushing the air out of the way as it falls down. And so is this one pushing the air out of the way as it falls down. And so this all streams now sort of funneled in this direction between the two bowling balls. Now this one sees this huge headwind coming up at it and gets kind of knocked out of the way by that giant headwind. So maybe this one gets knocked over here. But now that means that I'm starting to line up my bowling balls all preferentially over here, which means they're generating an even stronger headwind, knocking the gas out of their path. So this process runs away. And then potentially, if this were instead of our atmosphere with bowling balls, a swirling disk of dust around a new star, form a giant planet or asteroid seed by having all these bowling balls collapse together under their own gravity. The next steps from here are really working out the consequences of this for this broad range of systems. And we're trying to convince a lot of other people in the community to start exploring this because there's so many different aspects of these that we can't hope to explore them all ourselves. We've started even talking to people in volcanology lab, looking at what they think is an example of this instability that they'd seen as volcanic ash settles out of the atmosphere. There's really an infinitely large family of different instabilities that can all be characterized through a very general formalism, but are really ubiquitous everywhere.